another Gibson product. This one should be straight ahead too. Me be thinking. But once again, let's just see what we got before we start making it what it could be.
Right then.
Is it tuned?
Sounds pretty good to me.
Right now. Spin the wheel. The neck is way too straight. Okay, now we've established that. String height, what's it up to? Well, the string height is sort of where it should be, but the neck's too straight, so that's probably why it's quacking out and choking out. So, get the strings off and go at this one too. Once again, it's that drama part of the movie where we're gonna see what's actually under there. Let's see if it's all lacquered over and painted over. Nope, this one's clean. Sort of looks like someone may have adjusted it. But anyway, like we said, the neck was way too straight, so we're just gonna relax that a bit. Well, it turns. That's a good thing. Let's see what we ended up with. Okay, well, I relaxed it too much. Interesting. I didn't think I turned it that much. It must work really well. I can roll with that. Sure. Okay, I didn't show this in the other last video, but yeah, Fred erasers and a little help for the fingerboard is what it's getting next. Someone was asking about it's okay to use Fred erasers without protection on the fingerboard. Well, it is if you don't push down like a gorilla. They're flat, they span the tops of the frets. Makes a funny noise too, sounds like a frickin' seal. Okay. She's all cleaned up. Let's string it up and see where we're at. Okay, it's got all new string things. It's tuned up. And Siri says, neck relief is pretty damn perfect. Might release it just a little bit, just a tiny bit, but you see how I made the neck straight, and then we added strings and it just did its own magical thing, almost perfection. There we go, that's it. String height, geez, I could be having a sandwich. Geez Louise, I could be having a sandwich in no time, or not. Once again, I already noticed that the pickups are set way too close to the strings again on this guitar. So we're going to fix that. Right now, 564s on a low E. That's rocking solid. And we're sitting a little on the high side on the high E. Mainly because that should be 364s. Yeah. Needs a little help. Okay, just retune and make sure all the frets work. I guess I could turn it on. good enough. Let's look at this pickup height debacle. Right, so that's an eighth of an inch piece of brass. Push that down. That should slide under the pole piece. So once again, those are way too close. What's it doing on the treble side? Wow, almost touching. But then again, I did adjust the string action to where it should be. So that would have a lot to do with it. These got to get sucked way down into the guitar. Try something like that. I'll be back. Nice, that's set. Once again, we'll just check what they gave us at Gibson for first fret action, way over here, sort of. Once again, lovely 18 thousandths. And see, on this Les Paul, or on this Gibson, they've cheated it just slightly below 18 thou on the treble side. Plus or minus 3 thou. It's still, you won't detect that with your fingers. Once again, a little installation for the nation. I could be off for a, I don't know, what's it going to be today? Corned beef? Get flagged. G string seems okay. Yeah, I'm almost out of this, guys. Again, thanks for hanging out. This was an easy one. Just another quick check. Make sure that the strings are banging off the back of the bridge. And we got nice clearance there. That's fine. It's all good. It's all good. Trim the strings. Put a little truss rod cover on there. Just one more time. Just because I can. Before I put it in the stand for a day. Just... Yeah, that's really nice. Yeah. Beautiful. Till next time, folks. All the links are below. Shout out to all my patrons, Facebook people. What else? Twitter me. You can Twitter me. I don't Twitter too much, but I sometimes do. And, what else? Try and enjoy the last of the good weather and be good to each other. Cheers.